What's that?
What's your nickname for Brian Dable?
Dable. Dabes.
No, what does he call you?
Oh. Pierce.
He basically just shortens every last name, is that right?
It's like Naj, Tu, Jake, Rid.
Ridley?
I thought that
was kind of funny.
What does he
call Saban? Say Bear. Coach. Is that how you expect this to start?
No. Nice. Started off nice.
On that same kind of same note, how have you seen Brian's offense expand since he's kind of got more comfortable with the players? And, you know, as players, do you kind of know what's coming, you know, in certain situations? Okay, I have a feel for what he's going to call or what?
No, I think he's just a really smart offensive mind. I think that we've kind of noticed that. And just the way that he goes about his business is very professional-like, that we as players have kind of bought into what he's, you know, selling us. And just really just trust in what he's, you know, going to put out there on offense. And so I think that just gives us confidence. And I think, you know, the coaching staff too, just knowing that we're going to go out there and be able to execute. So I think that's kind of one of the main things that's, you know, we've noticed is just how he goes about his business.
How much fun is it when you guys have two defensive ends in the backfield? And I don't know what to call the package.
Are you talking about with Payne? And, that's fun to just see those guys, you know, run out on the field, and it's kind of like everyone knows what's going to come. So it's just for the offensive line, it's, you know, a big challenge. But, you know, we get excited when we see those guys run out, and we know we're about to, you know, kind of try to pound the ball down. So
since everybody knows what's coming, what's the play call then? Or what's the name of the play at least?
It's just a package, and they got multiple different.
There's nothing that yell on the sideline that – to let them know they're going in, or
no? I mean, it's just like I don't even know what it's called, but they just run out.
Is there a sense of invincibility though when they come out there? You guys kind of feel like, I don't think you've missed the fourth down yet.
It just gives us confidence knowing that we got bigger bodies in there, and they're just gonna, you know, blow up the field and try to blow someone up. And definitely doesn't hurt to have guys like Deron Payne back there to help lead the way for our running backs who are already, you know, tough as it is. So
they come up behind you, which. What's that like?
I'd like to think they do, but just kind of whatever happens.
They're coming into, like, when you're pushing, they're coming behind, is it?
Yeah, it's more like kind of the right side, but it's each block's important. Okay. Obviously. But just depends on the defense that they play and where the hole opens up. So,
just from your view, what do you see from these three freshman wide receivers?
I think they bring a lot of athleticism and explosiveness. Rhodes is, like, as I'm sure now, Scott, 5 passes for 5 touchdowns, so that's big time. And just to have talents like we do like that, and just to be a deep wide receiver core, has really helped our offense and just given us different looks and stuff like that. And so I think it's, you know, helped our passing game in the past couple games too, so it's fun.
How has Josh Jacobs matured into a leader on the team since his freshman year?
I just think, you know, he's gained a lot of trust whenever he goes into the game, knowing that he's going to do the right thing. He's just a really good, complete running back. I mean, he does it all and runs really hard all the time. As an offensive lineman, you know that he's just going to hit the hole, do the right read, and just know what he's, you know, going to do. So it's fun for him to be out there and for us to play, you know, with him. So.
I was thinking with the running backs, has it changed for you at all as they rotate in and out? Who's back there?
No, not really. Coach Burns does a really good job with them, coaching them up, making sure they do the right reads. So they're all pretty similar. It's just, you know, each guy brings a little bit different style of running to, you know, the game when they come in. So,
how's Cam Sims in the locker room? He seems like a guy with a lighthearted personality, kind of clowns around when he's out with us. It's the same way.
Yeah, he's a, you know, goofy. Cam's a good guy though. Goofy, loud, just kind of always, messing around with guys, but having a good time. And I think since he's been here, he's always just been lighthearted and had a good time. Enjoyed it. So
in a program like this, do you need those kind of guys in the locker room? Do they lighten the room?
Yeah, definitely. And I think if you don't have those guys, that it can get a little rough and kind of a grind. But when you have guys like that around, it just makes it fun. You know, more practice and stuff like that. And guys in the locker room just kind of taking it easy. So definitely makes it more fun.
How's it been for you personally, just blocking and just learning the scheme, just growing as a leader?
Yeah, I think better. I think kind of in my mind, I've just thought, let's just go out there and play. You know, I've played enough games now where I don't need to be thinking about this guy's going to do, and it kind of, you know, I think slowed me down in the past and just trying to think too much about what's going on, and just to go out there and play like I've seen, you know, all the looks that I can possibly see, whether it be in practice or games. So I just think that's helped me play better, faster, and just with more confidence, I think, when we get out there. So.
Do you think about LSU at all this week?
We haven't yet, no. It's just more been self-scout, kind of looking back at things that we need to improve on ourselves, things we've done good, things we've done bad. And then, you know, coaching staff has done a good job of kind of telling each guy individually things that he needs to improve on. And I think we're just trying to take it each day and focus on one thing. So.
Well, the coach has told you that this is something you need to focus on down the stretch.
Just some man blocks on, like, inside zone. You got a 2-eye inside me. I think that's a tough block. Just focus on that, just technique stuff, and then just like hand placement and punch in the passing game. So.
Go back to that game last year with LSU. You guys, maybe I think it was your lowest offensive output of the year. What do you remember for that game, and what could be improved?
Try not to remember too much of that game, but no, I mean, they played us well. They had a good you know, game plan coming in, gave us a hard time. I just remember, yeah, like you said, it was a hard offensive game, and I mean, we didn't get points until late. Or whatever it was when Jalen made that run, but yeah, I mean, it's gonna be a tough game. You know, I know that they're a good team and gonna come in here, and you know, we're gonna have to be on our game. So, yeah.
Hey, has anybody said anything funny to Henry Ruggs regarding the touchdown streak? Whether it's been in the offensive meeting room or out of practice or just around the facility?
No, I honestly, I think during the game when he caught that, someone said on the sidelines, and I didn't really believe him. I didn't even notice that he'd done that, but. You know, pretty incredible for a young guy to have success like that, and just happy for him and happy for offense too. You know, I mean, credit to everyone when stuff like that happens. So.
Thanks, Ross.